Welcome to Your Voice. I'm Julia Lilkendy. Today, Senator John DeFrancisco is here to talk about what's happening in the New York State Senate and Central New York. How are you, Senator?
Doing well. We're going into the last 2 weeks of session, which should be, it's usually busy, it'll probably be busier this time around, and there's a lot of political overtones with the governor indicating that he's trying to primary some of our partners in the independent Democrat conference, which could make things very dicey. So it's not only governing, it's governing in a political atmosphere during an election year, which is often very, very difficult.
All right. Before we get into the legislation, I want to remind your viewers that you have an event coming up, another one of those, Recycle Your Old Electronics.
That's correct. It's June 12th, 9 to 2, 6005 Fair Lakes Road, East Syracuse. Is a Time Warner facility out there. And we've partnered with Time Warner before, and I know I have at home some electronic equipment that doesn't work anymore. And it just sits around in the basement or in the attic, and you can't put it out in the garbage. You can't put it on the street. So we're recycling it, and the double benefit is that by weight of the recycled items, it could be an old TV, it could be an old computer, it could be an old whatever. They'll determine the weight of these items and give a small amount, but some money that we'll donate to charity.
Right, and the local charity this year is the a newly formed organization, Flags and Flowers for the Veterans, which is children putting flags out on East Syracuse Cemetery.
Yes, so it's the money that's made isn't a heck of a lot, but it's a good cause and good thing for the kids to honor veterans. But the most important thing is to keep this e-junk out of the waste stream and keep the landfills clear of it.
Right, just in time for some spring cleaning.
Correct, exactly.
A while back, you asked constituents on our show to recommend the best teachers, the teachers that are making a difference in your community, and I understand you had a ceremony to recognize those teachers.
Yes, you know, this is a time of time in our history where teachers are always criticized, and maybe that they're not doing enough or that the kids are not learning or whatever, and it all falls back on the teacher. But you know, the fact of the matter is the teacher's job is the toughest it's ever been, and it's always been difficult, but it's tougher than it's ever been, with new standards, with new evaluations, much of which doesn't make sense, with kids coming to schools that aren't prepared or not getting parental support more so than ever. And the teachers are really almost the parents during the day and even after school, and are expected to teach as well. So with all of this negativism on education, I thought we got to really recognize those teachers who are doing great things. And so we put out the call, and people, whether it's a student, in one case it was a parent who has two autistic children, recommending a teacher because of what the teacher does for children with autism. It was each one was an amazing story, and it's the first time we did it, and it went extremely well, I think.
All right, so let's put up a picture, and why don't you recognize who these teachers are?
All right, there's Wendy Smiley, Baldwinsville School District, Lisa McComber of Blessed Sacrament, Renee Brown of Cicero North Syracuse, Carol Goner of Cicero North Syracuse, Kathy Reichel of East Syracuse Manoa, Lauren Van Wee, a homeschooler, which was an interesting person to have because homeschooling is an important part of education. Melinda Smart, Jordan Elbridge, Karen Horrigan, and Dan Bongren, also of Jordan Elbridge, where we had the ceremony. Jennifer O'Malley, Jordan Elbridge, Joe Miuccio of OCM BOCES, so we had BOCES teachers as well. John Stephen Melfi, Onondaga Central, Peter Chapman, Skinny Atlas, Kathy Jerome, Salve, Sandy Ladd, West Genesee, Debbie Quick, West Genesee, Doug Heath, West Hill, Jeremy Augie, West Hill, Marianne Gloss, West Hill, and Mary Ann Dowling of West Hill. And hopefully they can pick themselves out of that that photograph. But all great stories. One was a very interesting one. I don't want to mix it up now. The person who nominated one of the teachers was a former student who is now the teacher's brother-in-law. Figure that one out. So that teacher's been around for a while, influencing people throughout the community, and it was a good event. I think everybody enjoyed themselves. Everyone appreciated the concept that, you know, it's about time we don't get bashed anymore. That some mm-hmm. people are doing great things should be recognized.
Right. And good teachers are appreciated.
And they are, and we're going to keep doing this. This is our maiden voyage with it, because of the atmosphere, you know, about schools and teachers. It's time to turn that tide.
Mm-hmm. So good role models are often hard to find, but as you saw, you just spoke about, the teachers are good role models. A lot of kids are getting involved in drugs, and the drug of choice these days seems to be heroin. The numbers are rising, and I know the Senate is trying to do something about that.
Yeah, you know, it's amazing. When I was younger, there was a time I was a lot younger, and when you heard the word heroin, it's almost like, oh my God, this is horrible, horrible thing. No one would ever get involved in it, except in most unusual circumstances, because of the danger around it. Mm-hmm. Now, when we tighten the laws on prescription drug abuse, it's taken that type of drug out of the community, since doctors are monitoring more whether a patient's going to one doctor, getting a prescription, another doctor, and so forth, and get another prescription. So they're being monitored by a new system. So that took that drug off the market, and all of a sudden heroin comes in, which is the cheapest of these drugs that are left in the field. Now that is truly scary. Mm-hmm. And I'll tell you what's really scary. Over the last couple years, or maybe it was the last year, that deaths from heroin overdose have increased in Onondaga County by 500%. You know, this isn't something that it's over there and it's not a problem. Mm-hmm. So the first thing the Senate did was to pass a bill, and the Assembly did as well, which makes more readily available Narcan, a drug that can, a person in an overdose situation, if it's administered in time, that could save the individual, and has on many instances, and police officers have been getting more access to it than hospitals and the like, so that there's something that can be done. And let me point one other thing out. We talked about this in prior shows, and that is a bill that has become law where if you have someone in an overdose situation, call and get help. Because in this situation, the help may mean saving this person's life, and you won't be prosecuted if you were not a drug seller at that time, but someone there when something happens. And so all these things tie in together. So that's what we've done so far, and we've got a series of other bills that we're going to be putting up this week.
Right. And another major problem, it seems, is that the kids who are trying to get treatment are often denied treatment or not in for long enough to get rid of this drug from their system, and that's something that you're trying to do.
It's correct. We've got to provide more treatment. We've got to make sure the people that are selling this stuff are prosecuted adequately and given longer sentences, so that shows we mean business. But also, you got to make sure that someone who's got a problem just isn't given the Narcan and go back home and wait for the next problem to occur. And so there's a series of bills that deal with treatment, and that may mean substantial treatment over a long period of time. And so this is a serious problem. If deaths were overdose in Onondaga County by 50% in 1 year, 500% in 1 year, you know, this could be an epidemic very, very quickly. And that's why we're passing a lot of legislation to deal with it.
Right. And what could be more important is to educate, and there's also measures for education.
Yes, and I hope the word gets out that, you know, this is that terrible drug that everybody we used to fear when I was young. It's a terrible drug that that's the most difficult drug to avoid dependency on. I mean, from what I'm told, you take heroin for a very short time and you're dependent. Mm-hmm. It's not something you could just break the habit very quickly. So You got to get treatment. Got to get treatment early and as long as you need it in order to break that habit.
Yeah, you talked about the what you think of when you think of heroin. I had the same visual, but then when you see the people who are involved in that drug right now, it's completely different. They look like your neighbor. You know?
Well, see, sometimes things don't get dealt with very quickly if it's always over there. And there's no problem because it's always over there. But we're talking about young people, anywhere that could get involved with a dose of this, thinking that, well, we used to try this, we tried that. Well, when you try heroin, it's a different ball game. Mm-hmm. You're going to be hooked, dependent, and it could ruin your entire life, or it could result in death. So this is an important effort that the Senate's making. The Assembly, no doubt, will pass a series of bills. Hopefully they're exactly like ours so we can get these laws passed. And the bills passed in both houses so the governor can sign them.
Another issue is marijuana for medicinal use. And a lot of people are talking about that. And as the session rounds out, people are kind of wondering if this is going to get passed this year. It's something that has kind of been talked about for years. What do you think about it?
Well, we've had hearings, I think 20 hearings throughout the state on this heroin issue. And the people that were at the hearings, and there's testimony that was taken, those that got into heroin almost uniformly had their entry drug marijuana. Now, I know the people that are pushing for medical use of marijuana says, well, we're not looking to become druggies, we're not. But the more you have something available out there, the more likely it's going to get in somebody else's hands. And I have a very serious concerns about it, especially when all of the claims as to what the drug does, it hasn't gone through the FDA, it hasn't been tested, and I'll give the governor credit that his proposal is to do some testing in 20 hospitals with the use of medical marijuana or marijuana for medical purposes, see if it is really does what people say it does. And if it does, then you can consider it when the testing is done. This is a funny game. People play politics no matter what and how honorable the organization is. I've asked, I don't know how many people who come in to see me that are a member of the Cancer Society, the Heart Association, what do you think about medical marijuana? Well, we haven't taken a position yet. Every single day you hear of ads about stop smoking. I saw one this morning where it showed the throat, when the smoke's going down the throat and every drag that you take of that thing could possibly activate a cancer cell and you're gonna, I don't get it. I mean, there must be some testing on smoking other stuff, especially if they don't have it. It should be done before someone makes a decision on a medical marijuana. So to me, if it works, we'll deal with it at that time. But you just got to be more research on it, and that's my position.
But you don't also have to smoke it. There's the oils that help the people with epilepsy and just other things like that.
Correct. But the bill that's currently being considered talks about everything. And I've talked to the advocates that I said, well, why don't we forget the smoking. If there's liquid that helps children with seizures, if there's ointment that'll help this and that, or liquid, let's do that and let's see how that works. No, it's got to be the whole thing because this is very, very important. So that's what's going to be one of the big issues that is going to be discussed for the last 2 weeks of session. Mm-hmm. And if you got a point of view on it, write me. Let us know. And by and large, overwhelmingly, the support from the information I'm getting from the medical community is you shouldn't do it.
Really? All right. Well, we'll talk about that in a future program.
Okay.
Thank you so much for being with us, Senator.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching Your Voice with Senator John DeFrancisco. Don't forget about the electronics recycling drive Saturday in East Syracuse. And for more details on what we discussed today, defrancisco.nysenate.gov.